It's believed Ben Alexander died instantly when his Honda sedan collided with another car at the intersection of Bennett and Desborough Roads at St Mary's. Three other Penrith players travelling with Alexander have been hospitalised. Wasn't wearing a seatbelt when his car collided with another vehicle at the intersection of Bennett and Desborough Roads at St Mary's. He died instantly. Three of his teammates, Scott Murray, Glenn Lydiard and Luke Goodwin, have been hospitalised. Murray's in a serious condition. Lydiard and Goodwin are under observation. News of the tragedy spread quickly to Penrith Leagues Club, and Alexander's older brother, Panther captain Greg, rushed to the accident scene where he broke down and had to be escorted away. Ben Alexander was a member of Penrith's victorious grand final side last year. Paul Bentley, Sydney.
Ben Alexander, larrikin, footballer, and a good little bloke. He was all those things. He was liked. In fact, he was loved by everyone who knew him. When news came through late on Sunday night, June 21, that Ben Alexander had been killed in a car accident, a community mourned. I had to do the breakfast show the next day. I've never seen anything like it. We had phone call after phone call from disbelieving listeners, just hoping that their ears had deceived them. We had people crying over the phone. Well, some people never know what it is to share true friendship in their lives. Ben Alexander had many, many friends. Some of the closest were the people with whom he shared the most time, the footballers from the Penrith Club. People like John Cartwright.
Well, you get to training sometimes and, you just think of, you know, he was always having something to say. He was always, you know, taking the mickey out of someone, and you just sort of find yourself in situations saying, you know, if little Ben was here, he would have said this and he would have said that. So he was just such a character, and he was, you don't realise, I suppose, until they're gone, what a character he was.
Ben epitomised the battler who won against the odds. His weapons to take on the world were incredible family support and the love for life that had instilled in him. He was relaxed and he was comfortable in anyone's company. His humour was always sharp and he was delightfully self-effacing, but he wouldn't think twice about taking the mickey out of anyone who left themselves open to attack. A lot of people thought he'd never make it as a footballer. His brother Greg had already established himself as one of the Panthers' all-time greats. By the time Ben came to grade during the 1988 season, he was smaller, he was slower, and in contrast to Greg's sleek athletic build, Ben had a tendency towards the chubby side. But he worked hard to cut the grade. By 1990, he was emerging slowly but steadily through the grades. My current co-commentator on 2KA, Daryl Broman, was assistant coach at Penrith in 1990.
Yeah, he was still very young then, and when I was involved with him, he was sort of just on the brink of forcing his way into second grade, and there were detractors at the club who didn't think he was going to make it in rugby league, and I had a very open mind about it. I hadn't seen a lot of him at that stage, but as the season grew on, as we got towards the end of the season, he certainly did make an impression on me as a footballer, insofar as there were always question marks about his defensive ability and his ability to handle a higher grade, but as soon as he was thrown in there, he had an immediate effect on the second grade I'm talking about now, an immediate effect insofar as he could see he could handle it. He was usually thinking a couple of rucks ahead of most players, and he gave that side the organisation that they'd lacked previously in that year.
Ben was sure in himself. He was happy with the kind of bloke that he was. He didn't need to resort to bravado and ego to inflate his self-image.
It's ironic, I was talking to someone the other day about him, and they were telling me about, apparently he was at the ground one day waiting to play second grade or first grade, it may have been, I can't remember, and as a young boy came up and asked for his autograph while he was there, the lad said, "Gee, I like that shirt you've got on," or something like that. Apparently Ben took the shirt off on the spot, gave it to the young bloke and went down and got changed for football. So I think that sort of epitomises the sort of guy he was.
By 1991, Ben emerged as an important part of the Penrith first grade squad. He was being groomed to take over the hooking role from Roy Simmons in 1992. But injuries to Royce meant that he had to come to the fore quickly, and he rose to the occasion. On the field, he became a vital cog in the Panther machine as it rolled on towards its first ever premiership title. Off the field, his cheeky humour did much to form the unique character and spirit of the mighty club he left behind. And
friend ever did.
Roy Simmons, who at the time had all but taken the teenage Greg Alexander under his wing, remembers first meeting Ben when he was no more than 10 years old and watching him grow up to become the man who shared his jumper in 1991.
He was a cheeky little fella, but was loved because of that. But he had the ability to get away with it because he was always smiling. If we went and had a night out, he was always singing songs to us. He just had that character where you couldn't help but like the bloke. And even after I hope everyone takes this the right way. Even after his death and as bad as I was feeling, I was driving to work and I still could put a little smile on my face when I was thinking of all the good things that he'd do and his smiling face and so on. And I hope that in amongst all the sorrow and so on that everyone's going through, I hope someone today, if they knew Ben, takes a few minutes to just be on their own and have a little smile and think about of all the joy he brought us and his friends and the people he used to play with.
May the good Lord be with you down every road you roll. And may sunshine and happiness surround you when you're far from home. Be courageous and
pass behind him, following him through was Dunn has picked it up and continued upfield about another 3 or 4 metres before he's brought down by Patterson. 35 metres out from the goal line now. Simmons a dummy half down the blind side. Greg Alexander at first receiver. He dummies. He goes on his own. He's gone straight through. He's got plenty of support. Gives it to his brother Ben Alexander and puts him over underneath the sticks for the try.
Whilst the stinging pain of Benny's tragic and unexpected loss may ease with time, for the people who knew him, his manner, his humour, and his friendship will live on in their hearts. He touched a lot of lives, Benny Alexander, and he left us all with something special to keep forever.
You know, the best way I can remember him is the grand final last year when he played a big part in getting us to the grand final. He was very strong all year when Royce wasn't there, and he did a great job. And you know, when the grand final was picked and he never, Royce was in the side, he never had, you know, a sad look on his face. He always had that smile on his face. He was, he just was full of support for everyone, and I suppose he would have thought he would have used in the grand final as well, and he didn't, but he was the first bloke out on the field after the game. And, you know, if you see any of the photos of after the grand final, you would have swore Ben played the full game. But you know, he didn't. He missed out on all that, but he was still as happy as anyone on the field, and I think that just sort of describes him to a T.
Look, we don't want to remember Benny as... I don't want to remember Benny as someone who died in a car accident. I want to remember Benny as the little Arrogant that we all used to love, that would all sing the songs to us, and that we'd all like to get around and enjoy his company. And I'd like to remember him as... There's a bloke that, when you, like I said earlier on, used to share a football Guernsey with me, used to share a laugh with me, used to share a celebration drink after a game. It was part of just real good mateship between a lot of blokes. I'd like to remember him for all them things instead of, a bad accident that happened on a corner.
Ben Alexander was the type of bloke that everyone would like to know. He's the kind of guy that you just love to work with. As showed by the enormity of the public show of grief at his passing, he will be sadly missed by the public. As showed by the depth of sorrow of his family and his friends, he'll never be replaced. Here's Penrith Chief Executive Don Feltis.
Benny was a happy-go-lucky, full of fun, great little guy. I cannot remember seeing him at all without a smile on his face and a twinkle in his eye. You can bet your life that if there was some devilment going on, Ben was in there somewhere in amongst it. He was great fun. He was always the one to cheer everyone up with his one-liner. And whenever he wanted anything at all, he'd poke his head around the door in my office and call me Uncle Don. And I used to say to him, "What do you want now, Ben?" He often would drop into my office for a talk, and we had a really good relationship. He played 89 matches for the club, 30-odd in first grade, and I remember that he virtually won us the first grade game against Brisbane this season at Brisbane when he scored that try under the posts and put our club back on the tracks after the shaky start that we had. He was a very valuable player, and he had at least 10 years of football in front of him. And none of us will know just how good he would have been and what heights he would have reached in rugby league. I would really like to think that Ben's death will make us all, and particularly our club, stronger in the future. And our main goal now must be, in 1992, to try and repeat our 1991 success and do that for Ben. God bless him.
Just to ride on the wheel, and we never know when death will shake us, and we wonder how it will feel. So goodbye. But the time together through all the years will take away these tears. It's okay now. Goodbye, my friend. The love you gave me through all the years will take away these tears. I'm okay now.